Yogic pranams to all of you.
So you have a responsibility now. Don't be after too many practices. Hold on to one every day. Hold on to one. What may come, I am going to do that. In earlier, I was a J. Krishnamurti and philosopher. I used to revolt and react, my God, I used to call all this nonsense. But revolting, reacting, working, again going back, studying and practicing. Now I am realizing, what a freedom. What a freedom. And in that freedom there is security. In that freedom there is strength. In that freedom there is everything. Things simply happen. Are you not grateful to the higher ups? So what is that which is creating all these things? What is that? What is that? Please go into this. Every minute try to recognize this. And thank you, my Lord. Thank you, my Lord. Only thing we say is, okay, thank you, my Lord. You are giving me so much. You are providing me so much. You are, I don't have the words to share. Words to share. So the humility says, be disciplined, be humble. Do your japa sincerely without any break. Don't doubt it, I am telling you. Don't doubt it. Don't doubt it. Decide, I am going to hold on to this mantra. Whatever mantra blessed, I am going to hold on to this mantra. I do it regularly. If we develop this strength, this courage, this insight, then the rest is taken care of. This is what Gurudev gave me the message when I met him last. You all know what message he gave? Japya Jameen Bolo, kya chahiye? You want Japa or Jameen? What do you want? I was expecting Baba would give. First he asked, how is Kanwa project going on? Sadhana Vidyalaya project. I said, Baba, where is money? I am not able to do it because no money. He got very wild. What do you want in your life? Japya Jameen Bolo. Then I was not expecting this reaction from Baba. I thought he would give me a few addresses in Delhi to collect money. It was a tight slap. So I took nearly 3 minutes to gather myself. I was clean bolt. Then I looked up and I said, Baba Jap. When I uttered Jap, I could see the light in Baba's face. His eyes glow, and then he looked at me and he looked up and he said, Bete, mother is there to take care of that. You go. You do Jap, I will do Jameen ka kaam. And Baba is doing. So, friends, we are all traveling towards the space of freedom. And freedom means responsibility. Freedom means total concern towards humanity, towards mankind. That is freedom. Creating harmony, creating love, creating smile, creating healthy feeling to everybody. That is freedom. Not becoming selfish. Me, mine, 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 mine. No. So develop that personality. Develop that personality. And then the mantra is going to support you. Your own energy field is going to protect you from all the dangers. So that is called initiation. So you are initiated into a great parampara, unbroken lineage, started from Hiranyagarbha, the great golden womb of energy filled with dhi shakti, and it is continuously flowing like Ganga. You are all blessed in that way. So how you can connect yourself with the source, Hiranyagarbha? Only through meditation, nothing else. Inwardly meditation, outwardly working for the Guru Parampara. What kind of work? To spread this message to as many people as possible. What is that message? Message is freedom from all misery is the message. What is the message? Freedom from all misery. If somebody is suffering, I should be able to share myself with that person. That is the spirituality. Not creating temple and do puja and okay, we are all spiritual. No. If somebody is suffering, go there. Sit with them, help them, find out whether you can at least do something in that direction. If you become sensitive in that way, let me tell you, you see sufferings very close to you. Your own brothers, your own sisters, your own people, your own fellow beings. What an amount of suffering they are going through. What an amount of work we have in front of us. Is it not? In our own houses, what an amount of suffering we have. So responding to that suffering, how I can draw energy? Only through meditation, holding on to the mantra and requesting all the beings of my personality to sink their differences and come back to the source. So every day you have to work in that direction. Is the physical being, the breathing being, the intellectual being, the emotional being, all the beings, are they together? Are they together? Are they together? Or are they divided? If they are divided, why they are divided? Why they are divided? If you are able to do this much for 1 year, good. Next year, if you are all prepared, I will take you to the next level of sadhana. But you have to prepare. Don't say, okay, Guruji, since 5 years I have been with you, leave me. Very sorry. A person who has joined yesterday, if the deservedness is there, he will get it. It is not according to the seniority list. Seniority has no value here. I am telling you clearly, seniority has no value. It is the deservedness. You may say, Guruji, I have been working and doing a lot to Parampara since 10 years. You are neglecting us, and that fellow joined yesterday. It is the deservedness. So develop deservedness. If you develop deservedness, then the grace comes down. Grace will be there always with you, I am telling you, please. Grace is going to be there. As far as your material living is concerned, grace is there. But for the spiritual growth, your deservedness is your grace. Material, okay. Don't worry, lay low. Chocolate cow, bas. But as far as spiritual development is there, it is your deservedness, not anything else. Not how long you washed the vigraha and put chandan and put arati, no. It's not going to help you. That is not the association. It's only a technical fulfillment, and you are doing it, that's all. Like how you are taking bath, you are doing that. So develop deservedness for spiritual development. Bring people together. Please, share love. Don't put anybody into criticism or condemnation. Remember this. If you are a sadhaka, remember this. If you are putting people into that kind of scrutinization, it's not good. No. If you have real concern, sit with that person and find out what's happening, what are the problems he is going through. Everybody goes through problems. Everybody is influenced by so many factors, unseen. 90% of unseen factors which are controlling us, we don't know. 90% of unseen, only 10% is known factor. 90% is unseen. So how to understand that? We can understand through love, through sharing, through concern. That's all. Let those three be our instruments in dealing the realities. So thank you very much. May Parampara bless you. Gurudev bless you. Thank you. Thank you.